Good morning and welcome back to another episode of the Inca Talks through Alpaca Expeditions TV. Today we are going to have a very special video because we are going to talk about the most important squares in the center of Cusco. We are going to cover this square, which is San Francisco Square, also Regocijo Square, Nazarenas Square, and also San Blas Square. We are going to let you know all of the different facts, secrets, and history about these different squares and the meaning behind their name. It's going to be an amazing experience, and please join. We are going to begin with this square, San Francisco. The most important feature about San Francisco Square is having all of these different flowers and trees that are native from Cusco and Peru. All of these trees and flowers are different, and each one of them have different properties for medical reasons that were used during the Inca time and transmitted over generations until our time. These flowers and trees mostly have names in Quechua language, which was the language of the Incas. One of the most beautiful places in Cusco. We are now located in Regocijo Square or Joey Square. This used to be a really big square combined with the main square during the Inca Empire. It was so important that even the other sites were used as agricultural fields and also planned to be the residence of new governors. The Spanish invasion occurred and the plans changed. They, in 1555, commanded to constructing the houses that now we can see over there, making a division between these two squares. During the Inca time, duality was very important, and the main square was known as Huacaypata, or crying place, and this part was known as Cusipata, or happy place. The Spanish didn't have this kind of philosophy, and that's why they made the division and had this sector as a local market during that time. Once the Spanish came to Cusco, the meaning of this square changed. They placed the first Santa Clara convent here, and that was the reason why this square had that name. This used to be Saint Clara Square. Going forward during the years, also the seminar of the San Antonio Abad University was placed in this square as well, reason why they also called this square San Antonio Abad Square. The last change, and which made the actual name, was having the Nazarenas Beatory placed here, having the name that we know currently, Nazarenas Square. In this square we can also find a very important museum and a very important school, and as well one of the oldest schools just one block away, going through this street to find San Borja School. This
was a very important square during the Inca time and also during the colonial time, having different names but staying with the name of Nazarenes Square. Behind me we can find a statue of Manuel de Mollinedo, who was the one working to place the San Antonio Abad Seminary.
The last place in today's video is San Blas Square. During the Inca time, this used to be the Tococachi neighborhood. During the Inca time, there was a temple for the Iyapa god. This god was the representation of the lightning, thunder, and the storm. It was a very sacred place during the Inca time. When the Spanish came, they made this temple into their own, and they built the San Blas temple above it, in order to have a worship area for them. This made the San Blas Square being very popular during the colonial time, because this was one of the first churches made during the colonial time of the Spanish in Cusco. Nowadays, the square looks very different of what it used to be like. It was in 1990 that one of the most known mayors of Cusco, Daniel Estrada Perez, commanded the reconstruction of this square. So the design that we now have for San Blas Square was made on 1990, and the most important feature was this fountain. During the colonial time, we didn't have this fountain over here. It was made on 1990 and is still nowadays being one of the most popular features of the whole San Blas Square. We got to the end of today's video and we learned everything about the different squares that Cusco has to offer. Remember, Cusco is not only the main square, there are different many things that we can discover during the streets, in the different squares, the temples, churches, that we want to show to you. It's been a pleasure working with you in this video and letting you know all of the amazing things that Cusco has to offer as well. And thank you very much for keeping posted with the Inca Talks through Epicenters TV. Remember that you can follow us on social media that we are going to place here below, and that you can ask us any question that you may want to know. You can ask about facts about Cusco, you can ask about information about Cusco, you can book a tour with us, just let us know. We are going to be more than happy to help you as much as we can. It's been everything for today's video. Thank you very much again for keeping posted, and we are going to continue with these videos with the Inca Talks through Alpaca Expeditions TV. Thank you very much. I have a nice day.